Dear fellow graduates, thank you all for attending this wonderful video that the school has put on for us. It's a great way for all of us to get together just one last time to celebrate our success. It's troubling times with everything going on with the COVID-19 pandemic, but I hope everyone is staying happy, healthy, and positive. The best thing about our school is that we're close and we're always there and we're very welcoming. It's great to have such supports like this video to keep us going through the troubling times. I would like to commence my speech with a quote from Mark Twain. The two most important days of our lives are the day that we're born and then the day that we find out why. High school is the time to find out why. It's the time where we're developing into ourselves and discovering who we want to be and who we don't want to be.
Let's start out with grade 9.
It was a fresh start, learning how to open lockers for the first time, learning that if you're late to Mr. Wilkins' gym class, you have to sprint. We all were like little deer in headlights, but instead of being scared of cars, the scariest thing in our lives was when Miss Kirby decided to teach a lesson at full volume. Sorry, Miss Day's science class.
Let's swing down to grade 10. This was the year that we realized walking downtown, not really worth it. Also, this is the same year that we had 16% of our school as just exchange students. Some of us to this day are still talking to our friends from across the sea.
Now let's move on to grade 11. Man, grade 11 was tough. I wish someone warned me, or else I wouldn't have taken all those classes my mom wanted me to take. Thank you so much, Miss Day, for passing me. Grade 11 was hard, and it was a lot of decision making, and it really formed a big independence on all of our parts. It was a good year for building who we want to be.
Now, I know I didn't talk a lot about grade 11, but that's just how fast that year went by. Now we're already in grade 12, and our past 4 years have went by in a flash. This is the time where we're starting to get a little weary, as we're choosing colleges, we're choosing universities, trying to figure out what we want to do for the rest of our lives. We're just plain confused, and all four of those options are totally normal. Trust me, I'm pretty sure I was all of them at one point. However, this is the year where we mainly have to say goodbye to our friends and family and home that we call the high school.
Now the 4 years are up, and this is just the beginning of the rest of our lives. We have so many opportunities to come and so many new experiences to have. I'm very pleased to say that I was able to graduate with some of the most extraordinary people I had ever met. I can't wait to see what everyone ends up doing, and I'm sure we all do great things. Right now, I'm at the University of Guelph studying sociology, and I love it. Can't wait to hear what all of my peers are doing now. Thank you very much for listening, and I hope you have a great Thanksgiving.
Friends, family, staff, and graduates. I know that when we started high school, this probably isn't how we imagined our grade 12 graduation was going to turn out. However, we gotta work with what we have. And regardless of the situation, I'd like to take this time to celebrate all of the graduates and the people who helped us get to where we are today. Firstly, I'd like to say how surreal this is. Many of us have known each other for our entire lives, and growing up in such a small school, we were able to watch one another grow, experience the high highs and the low lows. And I cannot express how gratifying it is to see all of my peers make it to the finish line. As I'm writing this, I almost feel like a proud parent, which makes sense because for most of high school, I looked like I was in my 8th month of pregnancy. You know, like my water was ready to burst at any minute. However, I would like to say how genuinely proud I am of all of my fellow graduates, my friends, for making it to this point. It feels like almost yesterday we graduated from grade 8. And it feels like almost yesterday we had to sit through a grade 9 health class where Mr. Wilkins explained to us how genitals worked. But look at where we are now, graduating grade 12 and wishing we could forget that Mr. Wilkins explained to us how genitals worked. But in all seriousness, I'd like to take the time to thank the wonderful people that helped us to get to where we are today. Thank you to Ms. Fawcett for guiding us through these past few years and always having our best interests in mind. Thank you to all the office staff for making sure things were running smoothly. Thank you to the janitors who worked tirelessly to keep the school in pristine shape, and thank you to all the EAs and substitute teachers. Thank you to our new teachers and our old teachers for guiding us through this time and for teaching us year after year and for believing in us and pushing us to do our best. Thank you, Mr. Wilkins, Mrs. McDougall, Mr. Simmons, Mr. Jones, Miss Bell, Mrs. Wood, Mrs. Day, Mrs. Pickett, Miss Cameron, Mrs. Simmons, Mr. Fergal, Miss Kirby, and many more for not only being our teachers, but for being our mentors, for after-school talks, and for showing us kindness and compassion. Thank you from all of the graduates for guiding us to success in high school. I'm actually feeling so thankful that I bought all of the teachers' gifts. This is a gift for all the homework that you made me do and the exams you had me study for. So if you look under your seat right now, you will find a brand new restraining order. I feel like Oprah, because you get a restraining order, you get a restraining order, you all get restraining orders. I'm just kidding, but we are all genuinely very thankful for all of the staff for helping us reach this moment, especially the teachers. So thank you, thank you, thank you. Now I'd just like to take time to congratulate all of the graduates on all of our success and the futures we have ahead of us. I know this sounds so corny, but no matter what you do, I am endlessly proud of you. Whether you work in the trades, the sciences, or the arts, whether you go to college, university, or you just don't go, whether you grow up to be on TV or fixing the TV, as long as you are content, then that's what matters most. So as long as you're happy with where you are, then I'm proud. So never forget that you will always have one big, burly brown boy in your corner cheering you on wherever you go. And the reason I say this is because I grew up with my dad always saying this one thing to me. Time and time again, he would say, "Geez, you're getting chubby." No, he would say, "As long as you're happy, then that's the main thing. And as long as you're safe, that's the main thing. And you're here, that's the main thing." And in his own little way, he always reminded me to be present and that if I was happy with where I was, nothing else mattered. I see many of my friends already taking the world by storm. Winnie Stute is studying marine engineering technology at Georgian College. Reese Wilkins is studying medical science at Western University. Holly Becker is studying sociology at Guelph University. Raylene DeYoung is studying agricultural business at Algonquin College. Cherish Ashqui is studying journalism at Humber College in Toronto. Ashton Heathers went to Georgian College to study culinary arts, and Claire Patry is studying physiotherapy and occupational therapy at Georgian College in Barrie. And that's just a taste of what the graduates are doing, an amuse-bouche, if you will. Many of us, myself included, decided to take a victory lap or a gap year to catch our breath. Many of us dove right into the field of work, like Sam Bridge, who's doing an apprenticeship at RK Electrical, or River Jones, who's doing a co-op with Bruce Power. I'm more than proud to have known Jenna Bloodworth, Ali Berg, Kirtan Field, Nolan Gamashfree, Lauren Grunman, Robin Hopkins, Owen Melanson, Haley Hennessy, Caitlin Higgins, Landon Kinch, Jaden Linton, Connor Ashcroft, Eric Kinch, Journey Mepstead, Morgan Murray, Jonah Otterbein, Lucas Pennycook, Seth Sadler, Delson Stevenson, Emma Miller, Simon Buffalo, Hannah Scott, Gavin Millett, Sam Miles, Keith Rouse, Justin Bird, and Nadia Suksan. I'm so honored and blessed to know all of the graduates, and whether we met in kindergarten or in grade 11, know that I am so ecstatic to graduate with you. Seeing all of my peers be able to do what they love makes me infinitely proud of them, whether they are in the workforce, post-secondary, or just figuring things out. Like my father always said, as long as you're happy, then that's the main thing. And I think that's the true meaning of success, which is why I'm so grateful to know so many successful young individuals and be able to call them my friends. Thank you so much to all of the parents, guardians, and friends for supporting us throughout our high school journey. I'm so excited to see what this next chapter brings. Thank you.
When it rains, it pours, but you didn't even notice. It ain't raining anymore. It's hard to breathe when all you know is the struggle of staying above the rising water line. Well, the sky is fine. blinded by the colors, yellow, red, and orange, and green, and at least a million others. So tie up the bow, take off your coat, and take a look around. Well, the sky is finally open, the rain and wind stop blowing, but you're stuck out in the same old storm again. You hold tight to your umbrella. Well, darling, I'm just trying to tell you that there's always been a rainbow hanging over your head. If you could see what I see, you'd be blinded by the colors, yellow, red, and orange, and green, and at least a million others. So tie up the bow, take off your coat, and take a look around. Well, the sky is finally open, the rain and wind stop blowing, but you're stuck out in the same old storm again. You hold tight to your umbrella. Well, darling, I'm just trying to tell you that there's always been a rainbow hanging over your head. If you could see what I see, you'd be blinded by the colors, yellow, red, and orange, and green, and at least a million others. So tie up the bow, take off your coat, and take a look around. 'Cause the sky is finally open, the rain and wind stop blowing, but you're stuck out in the same old to your umbrella. Well, darling, I'm just trying to tell you that there's always been a rainbow hanging over your head. Oh, tie up the bow, take off your coat, take a look around. Everything is all right now, 'cause the sky has finally opened, the rain and wind stop blowing, but you're stuck out.